his virginity at 6 years old, he claimed. So if that doesn't tell you something about Will Chamberlain.
Demon. I mean, I've got him beat by straight out of the womb, although it was a C-section, but...
My track record so clean, they couldn't wait to just bash me. I must be getting too flashy, y'all shouldn't have let the world gas me. It's too late cause I'm here to stay and these girls know that I'm nasty. I sent it back to her boyfriend with my handprint on her ass.
What's going on, everybody? It's your boy Chris. Welcome back to Game Chat. Today's video is going to be me and Declan's joint top 10 for the NBA, our greatest of all time list. This is going to be the best list on YouTube.
Pause. It's Declan here. If you don't want to watch the full 17-minute video, the full list of our top 10 will be in the bottom of the description. Hope you guys enjoy. Watch till the end.
No doubt.
We're gonna be if you're watching this right, you're gonna hit
bro,
the share
this to all share this to all your favorite YouTubers and tell them to react to this.
Yes, especially Flight. I want to hear what Flight says because little side note, guys.
Hit up six rings of steel because we're trying to get.
We don't have Iverson in the top 10. So if you want to see a funny Flight reaction, watch this.
I've got a few announcements. Okay, before we start, we need to see who our first Discord member is or who we've got in the Discord so you can get a shout out. Okay, so we got Declan, call Chris. Who the heck is Jellybean?
What? Who is
this? Oh, it's Marion from your school, Chris.
Shout out to Chris's girlfriend Marion for joining the Discord. If you join it, I'll give you a kiss.
Joining the Discord, you guys should join the Discord too. We have had a bit of a hiatus. It's been about a month. To be honest, we needed a break. It's very like draining these videos, to be honest.
Yeah.
You gotta hit the like button. Chris's crew, you know, got me a job.
Shout out Alex, man.
Shout out Animal Farm.
Without further ado. Any Omega style.
You've got the evens, I've got the odds.
Yeah, let's fire it up. We're gonna start with the number 10 spot, which I have. Here at number 10, we are gonna have the Diesel Shaquille O'Neal. One of the most dominant players ever, if not the most dominant player ever. I mean, four-time NBA champion. Yeah. Times with the Lakers, carried Kobe, sorry ass.
Very true.
Two-time scoring champ without even shooting a three-pointer. Three-time all-defensive team, 14-time All-NBA, 15-time All-Star, three-time MVP, three-time Finals MVP, with a career average of 24-11. Something a lot of people don't know, too, is Shaq was considered so much more dominant when he joined the Lakers and from that point on, right? In my opinion, the best Shaq we ever saw was Orlando Shaq. He was running up and down the court. He was the most athletic big man we'd probably ever seen up until that point. Of course, like guys like David Robinson and stuff eventually. Mm-hmm. I'm pretty sure Shaq was before David Robinson. I could be wrong, but he may have been. He kind of paved the way. Like, Tim Duncan wasn't athletic, but Tim Duncan wouldn't get tired running up and down the court.
He wasn't a chunk.
Shaq dived into the crowd. He would freaking jump into camera and break backboards. Like, he, big men, like Ahmad Rashad said, the guy who hosted NBA something. I think it was NBA Jam. No, it was something. Anyway, he said that big guys wouldn't even bend over, and Shaq changed that.
All right, so coming in at number 9, I've got, if you just look at the Bears stats, he's the unanimous GOAT. No doubt. At number 9, we've got Wilt Chamberlain. He scored, he rebounded, and in the games where blocks were recorded, he averaged 9 a game. I think 8.8 was the exact number.
Yeah, that was ridiculous.
He was a terrible teammate. Like, he had to take a step back to win because he was so ball dominant, and he never trusted his teammates. And Chris, you said this earlier, he had a better team than the rival Celtics. With Bill Russell.
Multiple times, and he couldn't come through because he didn't know how to use people.
Yeah, he would be pulling down, he'd score 50 points, pull down 20 rebounds, and still couldn't beat Bill Russell in the season. The thing was, I think it was a new coach who said that he should start facilitating more, and once he started doing that, they started winning, but it was honestly just too late in Wilt's career to continue the dominance. But the thing with Wilt is he might be one of the most athletically gifted basketball players in history. He was a track star. He went on to play in volleyball. I don't know what leagues they are, but he went to play pro volleyball. He had like a 50-inch vertical.
He lost his virginity at 6 years old, he claimed. So if that doesn't tell you something about Wilt Chamberlain.
Demon. I mean, I've got him beat by straight out of the womb, although it was a C-section, but...
All right, at number 8, we have the man with the most deadly post moves of all time, right above Kevin McHale there.
Is it Alperen Sengun?
Hakeem Olajuwon. Alperen will be the greatest player of all time eventually, and the greatest Rocket of all time, but that is in due time. Hakeem the Dream Olajuwon, a 12-time All-Star, 2-time rebound champ, 3-time block champ, 12-time All-NBA player. Yes, every year he was an All-Star, he made an All-NBA team.
Raptors legend, baby.
2-time Finals MVP, 1-time league MVP, and that's something a lot of people need to understand. When you're playing in an era, like, it's different nowadays because they don't try to give the MVP to the same player, the most valuable player every year, because LeBron would have more than he does.
Yeah.
Back then, it was the thing before the season. If you were saying anybody other than Jordan, no matter what the upside or anything, he's a 2-time DPOY, a 9-time defensive team player, 2-time NBA champion. He beat a stacked Knicks team in the year he did win an MVP. He was the only player to ever win a DPOY, Finals MVP, and MVP all in the same season. He beat a young Shaquille O'Neal when Hakeem was 32 years old in 1995. Finals MVP. Shaq even said himself, he said it about a couple players like David Robinson, Patrick Ewing, but he said Hakeem was the one player he truly could never stop.
Coming in at number 7, we've got Mr. Fundamental, Timmy D. Mr. Fundamental, his fundamental stats were perfect. I've said that 3 times because Chris keeps cutting me off. It's whatever. Tim Duncan is one of the greatest winners of all time. He's 1 LeBron fourth quarter away and 1 Ray Allen shot away from having 6 rings. He would be on par with Jordan. If he had that 6th ring, he could actually be higher on this list. I'm looking at it right now. He could be higher. Duncan's advanced defensive analytics, whatever you want to call them, clearly shows he's a top 5 defender of all time. Some people could even argue he's number 1. He ranks 2nd all time in defensive win shares with 106, just behind Bill Russell with 133. That's not even close. His defensive efficiency is also insane, which puts him with a defensive rating of 96. It puts him 3rd all time. Averaging 19 and 10 with almost 2.5 blocks a game, Duncan was a 15-time All-NBA and a 15-time All-Defensive player while winning 2 MVPs in the 2000s. One of the most underrated and most silent superstars of all time. Tim Duncan, one of the greatest winners of all time, literally propelled Greg Popovich to be one of the greatest coaches of all time. I think he's actually the greatest coach of all time, other than maybe Phil Jackson. All right, so coming in at number 6, we've got someone who I think is very similar to Tim Duncan in the winning sense and the defensive sense. We've got Bill Russell. He's the greatest winner of all time. 11 rings in 13 years with the Celtics during the Will era.
Who were as a player coach, though, so they're not as, like, they're still extremely impressive.
Mm-hmm. Russell also won 4 MVPs during the Will Chamberlain-dominated era. He also won multiple rebounding titles during the Wilt Chamberlain era. Like I said, averaging like 15 and 22 a game, as well as being quite possibly the greatest defender of all time. Bill Russell is our 6th greatest player of all time. Some people have him at like 10-9 alongside Wilt, but I think that's personally a crime. I actually have him higher than 6. Just we had to put him at 6 to make ends work.
Here at number 5, we have the Hick from French Lick, Larry Bird, Larry Legend, whatever you want to call him. The greatest Celtic. He's from French Lick, Indiana. 12-time All-Star, 3-time All-Defensive Team, 2-time Finals MVP. 3rd player of all time to three-peat the MVP, hasn't been done since. The rookie of the year in the same draft class is Magic Johnson. I said it hasn't been done since.
Oh.
Since. He's the last player to do it. All-Star Game MVP, that doesn't really matter. 10-time All-NBA team, 3-time NBA champion. And, like, I just want to put this out here. Back in the 80s, it was the East King and the West King. You had Tragic Magic Johnson, and you had Larry Bird, the two goats of their time. Mm-hmm. Anyway, Larry, 24-10-6 average over his career, 50 borderline 50-40-90 club average over his career. I believe he was the first player ever to do 50-40-90 club.
He might have been, actually. He invented
I think
the
stretch
fitting, so.
Yeah. Like, this is a guy whose defense is so underlooked. He was a top 10 defender at his position in his time, a 3-time all-defensive team. Like, it's just so wild to me how disrespect. Like, the people that say KD's better than him, you don't.
What?
Oh, yeah, you never heard that? You never heard that? People say it all the time to me, and I'm just like, all right, buddy.
Are you mental? There's a mental hospital in Whitby right here where you can go to.
It's like a minute away from my house. Swing by, I'll take you. This is a man who won a 3-point contest in a warm-up jacket. I think that's really all that needs to be said. Here at the number 4 spot, we have Magic Tragic, I Choke in the Playoffs, Johnson. The truest PG ever. Yep. Only rookie to win a Finals MVP, of course, it was against Philadelphia 76ers.
And he was playing center.
Center in the final game of the game that they won the series with. He only played 12 full seasons because of his illness. Let's just put it that way. At the age of 36, when it looked like he had more in the tank, he just had to call it a career because he said his love for the game wasn't there anymore. He missed 4 seasons where he still could have inflated his stats. Maybe won a championship with Worthy, stopped Mike. He definitely would have been in the finals, I feel like, over the Blazers in that year. Also a 12-time All-Star, 5-time NBA champion, three-time MVP, 3-time Finals MVP. He was on the 1979-80 All-Rookie team, of course. Didn't win Rookie of the Year because of Larry Frickin' Bird. 10-time All-NBA player. Like, people don't understand. You look at his stats, right? His career averages are 19.5, 7.2, and 11.2. And you're like, ugh, LeBron does that in a bad game. No.
Monkey do that any day. Coming in at number 3, we've got the all-time bucket getter. He's 3rd in blocks, 3rd in rebounds, 1st in general win shares. Kareem Abdul-Jabbar is the 3rd greatest player of all time. Originally, Kareem's name was Lou Alcindor. Is that how you... I thought it was Ankledor, whatever.
It's Lou Alcindor.
Whatever. He was a part of the most dominant and the most accomplished college team of all time. Without stats, this is the best way I can tell you how good Kareem was. The NCAA removed dunking. They removed dunking because Kareem was so dominant. And then they had to deal with Bill Walton. And then the NBA had to deal with
Bill Walton, man!
And then they had to deal with the fantastic coaching of Luke Walton. He's a 6-time MVP, 6-time champ, and he's the only player from 3-1 that actually has a legit GOAT conversation, because everyone up to here does not have one. They don't. Kareem is the first person on this list to have a legit GOAT conversation.
Here at the number 2 spot, this is tough for me to say, but I have to say it. Michael Jordan is number 2 all time.
Does that mean LeBron's not on our list?
No, we forgot about LeBron!
No!
Won 3 straight, retired, came back, won 3 straight again. I'd say one of the greatest, if not the greatest, rookie seasons of all time. Like, I think we can both agree on that.
Yeah.
Like 30 points per game, and then
that's
what
crazy.
He did in the playoffs.
That's crazy.
His second.
Fourth close.
Definitely, I agree. His second season in the league, he had to go up against the 86 Celtics, which at that point, and I still believe, is the greatest basketball team ever assembled. You got guys like Bill Walton winning Sixth Man of the Year, Kevin McHale, Robert Parrish, Larry Bird, Dennis Johnson, Danny Ainge. Like, that was a stacked team. Dennis Johnson is someone a lot of you casuals will not know. Look him up. He was a 12-time, I believe, defensive team player at point guard, 6'3". And Michael Jordan dropped 63 on his head and averaged 44 in that series as a 24-year-old, I believe, or a 23-year-old. Think about that. He has the highest work ethic ever. I'd say he's a top three guard defender of all time. I think that's fair.
I definitely think he's number two. You could even, like, you can argue.
Make the case for number one, definitely. I mean, a 14-time All-Star, 10-time scoring champ, 3-time steal champ, 6-time MVP, or sorry, 6-time NBA champion, 11-time All-NBA, 9-time All-Defense, the 84-85 Rookie of the Year, of course. The 1987-88 Defensive Player of the Year, 6-time Finals MVP, 5-time MVP, and like just ballistic, man. Just absolutely ballistic.
Coming in at number one, we have a Laker legend. One of the most loyal players of all time. Someone who came straight out of high school, declared for the draft. Laker legend, brought a championship to his team that he was loyal to. There's really nothing much to say about LeBron at number one. Really nothing much to say about LeBron at number one. LeBron's the type of player that you could ask, that if you needed to ask anyone, you could ask LeBron for a three. He'd drain it. If you need him to defend their best player, LeBron's here. If he's not lazy,
LeBron's here. If you need a floater from the three-point line, he's got you. The 2018, right?
It was 2018, yes.
That was the greatest player I've ever seen. He's over, ladies and gentlemen.
It's over. Rest in peace, Mac Miller.